In our pursuit to worship God, two things stand before us. To worship a man who has helped us to get what we have, or to worship what we have. So most of the time, we look up to what has saved us, and we look up to what we have, and we forget God who has given us everything. What happened was, if you go to Exodus chapter 7, verse 1, God says, Moses, I've made thee like a god unto Pharaoh, and your brother Aaron shall be like a prophet unto you. Whatever I shall say unto you, you shall tell your brother to say unto Pharaoh. So when people were delivered from Egypt, Moses was a god unto Pharaoh, not a god unto them. But as they moved in the desert, after Pharaoh was gone, they kept seeing Moses as a god, but not as a god unto them, but he was made a god unto Pharaoh. So you see now, when in Exodus 32, when Moses is going to meet God, who is God, not Moses, but in their mind, Moses was a god. So they come to Aaron and say to Aaron, Aaron, make us a god. Because the God we knew is gone, and we don't know what has happened to him. So when people looked at Moses, they saw a God that took them out of Israel, out of Egypt. But now, since they were in the desert and Moses is nowhere to be seen, to them, their God was gone. You have Christians today that if they don't see their prophet, if they don't see their prophetess, if they don't see their man of God, if they don't see their woman of God, to them, things have stopped. It's like God has gone out of their lives. Yet, a man of God or a woman of God is just a vessel who goes back to meet God to be given further instruction. But to us, we panic like we have lost God. And we seek other things. That's how the people came to Aaron and said, Aaron, make us gods that will continue with us in the absence of Moses. And see what these people do now. Aaron says to them, take your women, let them take away the gold and the silver, the earrings, and their daughters and their sons. Let them take away those earrings and those bracelets of gold and silver, and they would melt them to create something that they would be their new god. But see now, what they're taking off from their earrings and from their bracelets is what God said. If you go back where it all starts in Exodus chapter 3, God said, my people shall not go empty-handed. I shall give them favor in the eyes of the Egyptians. So they shall go and borrow gold and silver from the Egyptians. And then when they are given, let the women take these jewels and put them upon their sons and their daughters. So this is the favor of God that has been put upon their women, their children, their sons and daughters, as ornaments, as a sign of the favor of God upon them. But they are taking away that favor to create something they can worship. So they look at the favor of God to be their new god. They look at their blessings to be their new god. They melted the gold and worshiped it. Just like how you see today, people are now have taken bracelets as their guidance in the absence of the man of God. So they are told that if you don't see the man of God, and you have your ornaments, and you have the bracelets from the man of God. Do you see now, not any ordinary man made these things for them. They say unto them, Aaron, make these things for us. Make this God for us. It's not an ordinary man who can create such things, but it took another man of God to create such, so that this idol could release power. So men of God have got this power to release power unto objects. So, but it becomes idol worship. So it's not any man who can create wristbands. It's not any man who can create water that can have power. It only takes a man of God to speak power into these things. But when we speak power into these things, it's an idol that has been formed. A wristband has been spoken power into and offered sacrifice unto it. That's why we put them oil and everything. We We are sacrificing unto them, and by doing so, we have created an idol. That's an idol. That's when your man of God is away, you look up to a bracelet, you look up to water, you look up to those anointed materials, those handkerchiefs. Those are idols. We have asked our Aarons of today, our prophets of today, that make us idols in your absence, in the absence of God, so that we have certain things that we can ask certain things to get something. Be careful. Instead of enjoying our world, instead of enjoying our blessings, putting them as fashion. In the beginning, in Egypt, this was for fashion and style. They were never meant for worship. But further, when men got lost, they took this, instead of just fashion, they made an idol and worshipped it, and said, we have a God who will take us unto the promised land. Let me just tell you this. There's God in heaven, and he has sent men to deliver us. When God, there's this temptation to worship men. Because when God made, he said, let us make men in our own image, in our own likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish, over the cattle, over everything, over every creeping things. Man was given dominion over everything, but he was not given dominion over another man. So a man that has been given dominion over other men will got this temptation to see them as gods. Because only God is above other men. Don't put men in a position of God. No man has dominion over another man unless or until he has been given these people to guide them on behalf of God, not for God. So you realize what happens now, that with our current men of God, we have placed them above us, that we are their subjects. So they are in control of our lives. We have lost it. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, we belong to God, and all men are equal. It's only now when it says women subject yourselves unto your husband as unto the Lord. The moment you go under someone, you have made them like unto God. Let them remain like unto God, but they are never gods. They can be supernaturally anointed in a certain manner, but they are never like God. Say never, or say let's put an end to idol worship. May God bless you as you are led by the Holy Spirit. God bless.